What will I learn today? Sound. That sounds like fun. Oh, Energy Friend should hear my joke. Hello?
Cosmo? I can't hear you.
Hello, Energy Friend?
Are you on mute?
Oops, that's better.
What are you learning today?
I'm studying sound. What if I yelled as loud as I could? Would you be able to hear me on Earth?
Let's find out. I didn't hear anything. But that makes sense. You can't make sounds in space.
Yes, I did. I made the loudest sound ever. Skull and crossbones loud.
Sound is energy made by vibrations. An object vibrates, the air particles around it start to vibrate too. And this makes a sound wave. That's why I can't hear you in space, Cosmo. In space, there are no air particles. So there was no way for your voice to reach me on Earth.
What would happen if I made the loudest sound ever on Earth?
I'll get my earplugs.
Perfect. Start the simulation. We measure how loud a sound is in decibels. 20 decibels is a very soft whisper. 75 decibels is a washing machine. Whee! Sounds over 120 decibels, like a chainsaw, can damage your hearing. The rock band Led Zeppelin played some of the loudest concerts in history. A 1969 concert reached 130 decibels, and many people had to wear earplugs for protection. Louder? The loudest airplane ever flown was nicknamed Thunder Screech. At takeoff, the plane was 150 decibels. It was so loud that the sound waves gave the ground crew nausea and headaches. Earmuffs had to be worn or their eardrums would rupture. The loudest? Well, there are two natural disasters that are estimated to be between 300 and 315 decibels. At this energy level, sound waves transform into shock waves. The first natural disaster is the Tunguska event, a meteor impact in Siberia in 1908. The shock waves knocked over 80 million trees. Even as far as 40 miles from the explosion, the shock waves would have knocked you out of your chair and damaged your ears. The second natural disaster occurred in 1883. A volcano exploded on the island of Krakatoa. It was so loud that people over 3,000 miles away reported hearing the blast. The sound waves circled the globe 3 to 4 times in every direction. What would happen if there was an even louder sound?
Hello, Earth!
A sound this loud would produce shockwaves that would cause entire cities to collapse and trigger natural disasters like tsunamis.
Uh-oh.
A loud enough sound would not only destroy your hearing, it would blow you off your feet and even cause concussions and brain damage. Ugh, end simulation.
Oh my! Hearing loss is serious. Most hearing damage is impossible to fix, so we have to protect our ears. I love listening to music, but I never turn the volume all the way up.
Whew. Thanks for the information. Bye!
Bye, Cosmo!
Which chapter should I research next?
Cosmo!
Hey everyone, Cosmo here. The loudest sound ever sure was dangerous. What if we could do an experiment to safely show how sound waves travel? Step 1. Find an adult. Step 2. Gather a wooden spoon, a metal spoon, string. Step 3. Make a loop in the middle of the string and put the handle of the metal spoon in the loop. Pull the loop shut so that the metal spoon is hanging in the middle of the string. Step 4. Wrap the end of each piece of string around the pointer finger of each hand. Step 5. Place the string against the outside of each ear. Let the metal spoon hang straight down. Step 6. Gently hit the wooden spoon against the metal spoon. Is the sound different if you hit the metal spoon with different strengths? This experiment sure sounds like fun. I'll see you next time on What If Kids. Goodbye!